Dr. Ngozi Ezike is the director of the Illinois Department of Public Health. During normal times, most people couldn't tell you the name of the person who holds that position. But these are anything but normal times. The pandemic focused a spotlight on her with her daily updates by the governor's side. And with that spotlight, we witnessed the ups and downs of the overwhelming responsibility that came with that job. Sylvia Perez takes a look back with her 1 year later.
It was December of 2019 when the world first learned of this mysterious illness coming from Wuhan, China. The first case confirmed in the U.S. was on January 20th, 2020, a Washington State man in his 30s. Just a few days later, a 60-year-old Chicago woman becomes the second confirmed case in the United States.
At what point did you really start to become concerned?
I think we had these single cases. We had the first case, then the second case, which was confirmed, you know, shortly thereafter, was the spouse of the first case. So that wasn't as alarming. Then we got, you know, a third case, a fourth and a fifth. And I think it was by about March 13th, when there might have been like 50 new cases. Then it was like, oh boy, yeah, we're in for something.
It was something no one could foresee. Eventually, it affects travel and overseas. Other countries begin imposing lockdowns. Finally, on March 20th, Illinois becomes the second state behind California to impose a shelter in place. Indoor dining is banned. It was only supposed to last a few weeks.
You both received, I know, a lot of criticism for those lockdowns and closures.
We were operating with limited information, but trying to be cautious because lives were potentially at stake.
What was your hardest day during the pandemic? Because I remember one day where you broke down during a news conference.
For a total of 9,418 deaths. These are people who started with us in 2020 and won't be with us at the Thanksgiving table.
Looking back to that day, we were seeing the numbers start to rise again. Seeing history repeat itself, I felt the anguish and the pain and the frustration, I think, of the healthcare workers, that we were going to have to go through this really traumatic experience, yet a second round.
That second round meant more mask mandates, retail and restaurant closures. It was just too much for some Illinoisans to deal with. Dr. Ezike and her family become the target of hateful mail and packages left at her home by angry strangers.
I don't think that public health has ever been something that was debated or scrutinized in this manner before, but clearly we've learned that politics and pandemics don't go together, and unfortunately that marriage has resulted in additional lives lost.
One of the biggest criticisms against the state today, the vaccine rollout. But Ezike says Illinois is making aggressive strides, and in time, the vaccines will come.
I think we absolutely see the light at the end of the tunnel. I am waiting for more vaccines to become available, and there are assurances from the administration that they are coming. We just need people to continue to be patient. And unfortunately, that's a word that we've used for so long.
Sylvia Perez, Fox 32 News.